Well, Linda Burney has accused the No campaign of using Trump-style politics in its opposition to the Voice referendum. Our political reporter Olivia Caisley joins me in Canberra. So, Olivia, the Indigenous Australians Minister departed from her prepared speech to really take aim at Voice opponents.
Yeah, she did. She did go off script at one point there to really basically call out the No campaign for what she said was importing Trump-style politics and tactics and seeking to divide Australians. She also called out the media as well for not marking down politicians such as One Nation Senator Pauline Hanson for comments she said had been racist. Here's her rebuke of the No campaign earlier.
Do not let No campaign get away with using Trump-style politics in Australia. Do not let them divide us.
The main focus of the minister's speech today, though, was to try and reset the government's narrative and also try and allay concerns around the government's scope. She clearly has established goalposts of what the body will be able to advise on. So that's health, education, jobs and housing. And this comes, of course, after the government had previously shut down lines of questioning about what the advisory body would or would not be able to consult on. As you can see in this graphic here, there are those key policies there. It is a really delicate balancing act for Labor, though. On the one hand, they don't want to overwhelm Australians about the body's scope, but on the other, they don't want to get the Indigenous community offside if it's so supposed to be an independent advisory body with its own autonomy to consult on issues they deem important. Minister Burney moved to reassure Indigenous Australians today.
It's not going to be a passive advisory body. I want it to be active. I want it to be engaged. We need new perspective to old challenges, perspectives that are connected to communities. We need ideas that come from the people on the ground. We need a voice.